What's going on, guys? It's Zach Brenner here, and welcome back to another video. So, guys, if you are new to my channel, lately I've been doing a lot of day in the life videos because they are just a lot of fun. But today we're doing a little bit differently. Today we're doing a day in the life of Terry Crews on his cheat day. So I'm a big fan of Terry Crews. I think he's absolutely hilarious, and he seems like just a really nice guy. And also, he has a very, very good taste in food. So this video, did it yesterday, includes some of the nicest meals I've ever had. But the problem is being in Australia, we just don't get a lot of these meals. They're very American. For breakfast, we have apple fritter. For lunch, we have a pizza. For dinner, we have lobster mac and cheese. And then for dessert, we have a peach cobbler. These just cannot be found in Australia, except for pizza, obviously. So I had to make basically everything from scratch. So without further ado, this is a day in the life of Terry Crews on his cheat day. Okay, so today we are training chest and arms. Now, a few rules for the workout today. This is his actual workout, apparently. We can't listen to music, we've got to listen to audiobooks. So, not the worst thing. I mean, I do listen to audiobooks all the time. I'm currently listening to Limitless by Jim Quick, which is really good if you guys need one. And then our warm-up is gonna be push-ups, and then everything after that follows a rep scheme of 10, 8, 6, 4. So you're getting heavier each time. And then we go into a lot of supersets, so push-ups with dips, and then we start hitting some pull-ups. I think he likes to warm up biceps with pull-ups. Fair, and then dumbbell curls, and then barbell 21s, and then followed by a 4-mile run. So I've already lost it there because I can't run four. Literally, if somebody was chasing me with a chainsaw and I had to go for 4 miles, I'd honestly stop, turn back, and try to convince them otherwise. I just can't run. But anyway, that's what Mr. Crews does. Just reminds me of Coach Carter.
Mr. Crews,
what I gotta do to play?
50,000 suicides.
Damn.
4 billion suicides, Mr. Crews.
By Friday.
All right, so we're gonna get into it, starting with incline bench, and yeah, let's get it. Next up, Terry Crews has a very specific grooming routine that he follows every day, starting with shaving his head.
I shave it every day, and I have the exact pattern that down exactly how I do it, and then I put Old Spice aftershave on the top of my head, and then I use Neutrogena oil all over my body. But I get oiled all the way up. I look like a nice slick machine.
Good. So now that the workout is done, all the hard shit is over, and it is time to get stuck into the food. So for breakfast, we are gonna have an apple fritter, and the big guns can do the cooking today. So no more.
3, 2, 1, pan out with the camera.
I'm gonna be making the camera transition, so let's get to it. I'm very excited, and I'm very hungry. Cue cinematic apple fritter in 3, 2, 1.
You got to have the feeling, sure you're born. Get it together, right on, right on. Get up, get on up. Get up, get on up. Get up, get on up. Get up, get on up, get up, get on up, get up,
I'm so excited. I'm kind of put off that since you just came on these with a banana. Yeah, you just banana juice all over it.
The jizzy food. Evan?
Yeah, I got cum on my face. Minus the jizz. That's so good. Yum. See, I don't think we have, I mean, I hope this is what he was referring to when he said apple fritters, but we don't have this here. Mmm. So good.
Zach was 3 years old, he'd say, oh, I love it.
Fun fact, I actually used to everything. If I love something, it was, I love it.
Oh, I fucking love it.
So I fucking love it in 3. Mmm. But I do fucking love it. This is insane.
Oh my God. And what's that sauce?
Jizz. Yum. Oh, let's get more. Yeah, we're gonna put any more. Basically food porn slash actual porn. Also, guys, like this video if you enjoyed that edit. I'm hoping that was the best cinematic edit of apple fritters you've ever seen in your whole life. All right, moving on. Okay, guys, so it is time for lunch and we have pizza on the menu today. So I'm not gonna home make the pizza because for one, I can't be bothered, and two, I may as well just get some Domino's. And I thought to confuse them, I might give them an impression on the phone.
Domino's, morning, can I help?
Hello, can I please make a order for pickup, please?
Yeah, what was the name?
Zach.
Zach?
Yes.
I'm not gonna eat
today. Can I please get one large pepperoni pizza?
Pepperoni?
Don't get the pepperoni, get the butter chicken. Sorry, 1 second. Get the butter chicken, the pepperoni's disgusting. Do you do half and half?
Yeah, we do.
Perfect. Can I get half pepperoni, half butter chicken, please? Yeah, good.
Half pepperoni and half butter chicken, did you say?
Yes, thank you.
Is that okay?
Do you want a drink? No, I'm good, mate. That's fine. That's it. Thank you.
Yep. No, I'm just going to let you know that the large sizes are smallest, so that would feed about one person.
Yeah, that's fine.
If you want to upgrade it to the extra large, I can do that for $3 more.
Extra large? We have some? Yeah, go on then. We'll grab the extra large, please.
And any drinks or slices of that today?
No, thank you.
About 10 minutes.
Perfect. Thank you very much.
Have a good one,
thanks. I was even having arguments with Jamie Oliver by myself.
They just called me back and they said that some lady said that she made a phone order for Zach and then paid for it over the phone and then picked it up. But I had to call him back and stay in character the whole time. I'm like, that's crazy. Wow. I can't believe somebody took my pizza. I'm like, can you make me another one?
Let's get this pizza. Safety first. Done. Pizza is secured. Dead set, they literally just said, some lady came in there, said she had an order for Zach and picked it up. And I didn't even tell anybody. Are you pulling my bollocks? Are you jacking my Murph? Anyway, let's get this bad boy home. So lunch is served.
And actually, looks alright.
I meant to say barbecue chicken and I said butter chicken because I Jamie Olivered it. I made a mistake. Butter chicken, but I meant barbecue chicken. It's weird. Probably shouldn't be on a pizza. It's not bad, it's just too hot. It just tastes like curry on a pizza, so it shouldn't be a thing. Yeah, that's yours. Actually, gotten better.
I mean, did you damn see them today?
I haven't done any. I'm gonna get a count going for the whole video.
Oh yes!
Oh, so full.
Good work, Beth.
Good girl. Okay, so I just realized I completely forgot to get ice cream for dessert tonight. So I thought I had all the shopping done, but evidently not. So, you ready? So I don't think you guys have even met my missus yet, have you? Anyway, you'll soon see. This is my girlfriend. We're gonna go grab some stuff from the shop, but you don't wanna, okay. All right, anyway, let's go.
don't know.
I'm gonna listen to a little bit of music.
I love this song.
Making my way downtown, walking fast, traces pass and I'm homebound. And I need you, and I miss you, and now I wonder if I could fall into the sky. Do you think time will pass me by? 'Cause you know I'd walk 1,000 miles if I can just see you.
So.
Chop the onion.
Try, ready? Go for it. Ready? Go, Mum. Transition.
1, 2, 3.
So, time to make some lobster mac and cheese. So, I don't even think they sell this in restaurants or places here. I mean, I have never had it in Australia, but I've had it multiple times. How good is this, by the way? I edited the sickest sequences, as you guys just saw, all of that, and then it deleted it. So, I had to do it again. So, what you guys saw was the second time of me editing all of that stuff. So, wasted hours. Yes! But it's all good. Anyway, you guys want to know the trick of not to cry when you're chopping onions? Don't be a little bitch. That's missing a lens.
It's missing a lens. Well, how have you been?
Jesus. Well, you don't care about my right eye. These are seriously onion chopping glasses, no joke. But they're redundant glasses now because got no lens. My eyes, I'm blind. I'm basically blind now. I feel like Helen Keller making dinner. Oh, holy shit, that cheese is good. What was that? Hey Siri, how many degrees Celsius is 350 Fahrenheit?
135.
Cheese. That's a lot of cheese. I'm not a rat, but that's a lot of cheese.
You don't need to measure cheese though. You use all you've got, that's a fact. A recipe calls for cheese, you just use as much as you've got in the house.
There's three things going on, that's chaos. Hey Siri, set a timer for 6 minutes. I reckon I'm annoying the shit out of everyone at home right now. Nah, that's just flour and onion and garlic and butter.
Oh my god, that looks so good.
Look at the size of this. Pure heaven. How many calories do you think is in this? This is insane. All right, here it goes. Oh. It's one of my favorite meals, I reckon. That is so good. You never get enough lobster at restaurants either.
No.
They give you like it's just shaved through it. And this only took like 2 hours.
Terry Crews' family time. Now we go and watch your YouTube videos.
Yeah. Yeah.
But I like to watch anything I'm in. I'll watch Brooklyn Nine-Nine. I'll watch it several times.
That's so nice. That is so good. This is the best one I've had in ages. Yeah. All right, now the dinner is done, time for dessert. Making peach cobbler isn't an easy task, so I'm not gonna make it right now, but here's something that I prepared earlier.
more soul.
This looks so good. I tasted bits of it when I got off the tray, but so good.
Take some time.
If anybody's seen Juice Bigelow, please cop it. If you haven't, watch it. And then come back to this video and understand the reference. Hey Joel, quick, what pie has the most sugar?
Peach cobbler.
Did you say steak?
Did you say steak?
No, mistake.
Oh, see, now you got me all excited.
This is so damn good. Heaven. I 100% relate to Terry Crews on his cheat day. This has been absolutely ideal. Same again tomorrow. All right, I'm gonna finish this, switch that off, and we'll see you guys in the morning. So I hope you guys enjoyed that. Like I said, how good did that look? Like honestly, one of my favorite videos to film because I reckon with most cheat days, like you got The Rock's cheat day and you know he's not eating all that. Like, but this is a reasonable cheat day. It's not disgusting, you don't feel sick. I just felt awesome. Like I'd do it literally, I probably will do it this weekend. But now is the point in time where I give someone a shout out for giving me the idea of the video. So guys, if you want to get a shout out, all you have to do is comment below who you want to see next. Today's shout out goes to Shay Phillips, who's had a day in the life of Terry Crews, and I just kind of made it a bit more fun. So that is it from me, guys. I hope you enjoyed this, and otherwise, you definitely, definitely know what to do. Stay massive.